Today, I'm going to talk about what OpenEHR is and how you can use it. When you build software for healthcare, especially, let's say you're building something for a hospital, you first go to the doctor or whoever is hiring you and you ask them what the requirements of the software are. And after you get these requirements, you go and build this, right? You just start coding. And that is what OpenEHR says is what you should not do. You should not start doing that immediately. And I'm going to show you based on example how OpenEHR can be used. So this is a demo EHR that I built, okay? And it has nothing much right now. It just has my name, which is there, and I can search my hospital number, and there is really nothing here. And this is where OpenEHR says the content that is specific to an EHR should not reside within the software. You should instead make it separate. Okay, and how you can do this is by creating these things called templates and archetypes. So first I'll give you an example. Right now, let's say I'm making something for the emergency medicine department in Manipal, for example. And I'm going to create some sort of assessment form for when the patient first comes in. And I want to know two things when the patient first comes in. I want to know whether there is the pulse, whether it's present or absent, and I want to know the Glasgow coma scale. So these are the only two things that I'm interested in right now. So I need a form to enter that details. So how do I go about doing it? First thing you do is you go to the clinical knowledge manager in OpenEHR, and you search for these data points that you want. Now, in the initial assessment, I want two data points. First one being the pulse, and the second one being the Glasgow coma scale. So first, let's search for the Glasgow coma scale. So GLAS, and under observation, we've got something called the Glasgow coma scale. And you can see that they already have a lot of these things in place, like the E, V, M, total score, all that. So, okay, we have the Glasgow coma scale, and I'm going to search for pulse. So pulse or heartbeat is probably what we want. And again, this also has a lot of data points inside. So this is called an archetype. Now, this is the building blocks for you to create a more complicated thing called a template. So you first look at the archetypes that you want, and with this, you just assemble it like Lego bricks and make a template. So now how do you make a template? You go to a template builder. So for that, there is a thing by OpenEHR and Better. This is made by Better. tools.openehr.org/designer. And I'm just going to log in with my Google account. To make things faster, I've already uploaded all of the archetypes in the Clinical Knowledge Manager to the archetype designer. I'm going into MedBlocks. And you can see here that I already have a lot of templates and archetypes, but let's just create one from scratch. So I'm going to create an archetype from scratch, and I'm going to inherit from the encounter archetype. That's basically what people do all the time. I don't know why, but you can change it if you really like to. So this template is just called, let's say, example.initialassessment.v0. You need not name it like this. I'm just doing this for my sake. So I'm going to create that. And here you can see that it's basically empty. It just has some context, other context, and content. So content is what you provide to a template. What do you want to record? And the first thing I want to know is the Glasgow coma scale as soon as the patient comes in. So I'm going to search Glasgow, and here it is, GCS. I'm just going to click on that, and it has added that into my template. Now, I don't want all these things called like the comment, the confounding factors and all that. I don't want. So I'm just going to make it zero occurrence. And EVM profile also, I don't want. All I need is the E, V, and M. And you can see here that the archetype has automatically coded this with corresponding values. And the total score is also, you know, type of count. And these things are type of ordinal, which is basically a number and text combined together. So best direct response spontaneous would be 4. So on and so forth. So here I've added my Glasgow coma scale. And here you can see that under any event, it says it's 0 to as many as possible. If you come from fire, you must have already know what this means. So I don't want multiple Glasgow coma scales in my response. I just want one. So that's going to be there. And now I'm going to add pulse. Pulse slash heartbeat. And it has a lot of things, but when the patient initially comes in, I do not want anything other than whether the pulse is present or not, not even the rate. So I'm just going to cancel out every single thing. I wonder if I can just, no, I can't. So I need to cancel it out manually. And here it's any event, which can be, you know, anything like the maximum, the minimum pulse rate, anything. And here they have a separate tree for maximum. So I'm just going to null this. And the protocol by palpation, auscultation, nope, I'm not interested in this. Body site, again, I'm not interested in this. I just want to know if the pulse is present or absent. And again, this also, I only want to record it once in this template. And I'm going to just save this. And now we have made a template, a simple template for assessing a patient when they come in. Now, how do we import this into the EHR? The thing is, this is something that I made, this whole thing. So I can just add templates here. So I'm going to export this as a web template to my desktop. And I'm just going to add it right here. It's called example. So I didn't change the name. I could have changed the name to something more meaningful, like initial assessment, but that's what we have. It will show up as example.initial assessment. And when you click on this, you see that this is the name. I better change this name. It looks bad. So I'm just going to change this to initial assessment, save that, export that as a web template, and just replace that. So here I'm going to add this template again, and I'm going to disable the first one and also delete it. So now we have initial assessment. So once I click on this, you see that we get all of these fields automatically. Glasgow coma scale, let's say I4, best verbal response 5, and best motor response 6. And that's a total score of 15. And I want to see the pulse and heartbeat, and that is present. And when I submit it, this is the important part. Now all this, I did automatic form rendering using a template. That is also good. But most of the work in OpenEHR, up till now at least, has gone into making this data layer as uniform as possible. So once you get this output from something like an automatic form builder, this data can be stored in an OpenEHR repository. Now, an OpenEHR repository can work on any database, it can work on anything, but it comes down to representing something called the reference model. Now, the reference model is a specification given by OpenEHR, and they store everything as an instance of the reference model. So no matter which application is accessing this data, they know that for this template, it's going to be exactly the same no matter which application writes to it or reads from it. So this gives us a uniformity at the level of storage of the data. And not only that, this especially better says it in all of their presentations. A hospital system will require changing of the software every 10 or 15 years, and maybe even 7 to 5 years in the future. But every single time this happens, data gets lost. And that's because people store their data in proprietary formats. With OpenEHR, it's trying to change that. You store your data in this uniform format that is an instance of something called the reference model. And any application that comes after it can use the same data. So you have no loss of information when moving from one information system to another. And this also makes sure that when people compete, especially in health informatics, they compete using features and better pricing for the customer and not by keeping the data format proprietary. So I feel this is a really good approach to take when it comes to building health informatics systems. And this example was just a demo, and this is the flat format. And now I can just commit it to an OpenEHR repository and then do fancy things like querying based on template or querying based on even the archetype. So even if people use different templates, which people will, an application that knows that Glasgow Coma Scale is going to be represented by the Glasgow Coma Scale archetype from the CKM, the Clinical Knowledge Manager, can still take that and use it the same way. And here is where it differs a lot from FHIR, in that FHIR tells have your own profiles and, you know, just extend what you want. OpenEHR says you have a maximal data set, which is the archetype, and you cut down things that you don't want. And this makes it much more easier for application developers to develop things that work across the board with any archetype that they give. Because you know what an archetype is, and if you want to add a new thing to an archetype, you either have to make your own archetype or you make a request for comment to the archetype designers, and you have a collaborative thing going on there. So I feel this will definitely be the future of EHR development, and I feel that a lot of apps can run on the same clinical data repository. And even this is just a small example of how you can create an EHR that does not rely on the content. So these forms, these templates are completely up to the doctor to make. So if they want to change it tomorrow, they can easily do so. And so I feel that will be the future of healthcare, at least for the time being that I can see. And you can obviously also serialize this to FHIR. There is nothing stopping you from converting these data models into FHIR resources. In fact, EHR Base is doing an excellent project called FHIR Bridge. So this is a Java project which converts EHR Base compositions. So this is called a composition. This is a composition, and it converts that into FHIR resources. And the mapping has to be done manually, but at least you can read and write between FHIR resources and a composition. And in fact, the FHIR resource will be different based on each profile. I don't think Glasgow Coma Scale is something that is represented uniformly across profiles. In fact, even if you search Loing for the code Glasgow Coma Scale, representing the codes for each level might be different. Some might use the Loing code, some might use the SNOMED code. So here you have this sort of uniformity that you do not get with FHIR, that an archetype is an archetype. No matter where you put it in the template, it's still going to be there. And that is basically what OpenEHR is. I hope this helped you learn a little bit more. And if you have any questions, let them know in the comments below. Thank you.